The Department of Public Health and Human Services is pleased to bring you Aging Horizons. Medicare, Medicaid, Social Security, fraud, legal issues, veterans benefits, and caregiving. Aging Horizons is a program dedicated to inform and prepare Montanans on these timely issues, making a difference to you and your loved ones. Here now is today's program host.
Hi, folks, and welcome to Aging Horizons. On today's show, we'll be talking about the Governor's Conference on Aging. It's coming up September 14th, 2021, and this year it's going to be virtual. You can see it or watch it at the local senior center or at the convenience in your own home on your computer. We'll be talking about what issues are being presented and why it's important for you to watch, so stay tuned.
Flight 109, is that Evel Knievel on the runway?
Whoa, Daredevil, you need a Montana Real ID to fly. Go to mtrealid.gov to make an appointment.
Looks easier than jumping a canyon.
Smile. I see you changed your name from Robert to Evil. Did you bring your name change documentation?
I'm not trying to pull a stunt. Got the paperwork right there.
Go to mtrealid.gov.
Now I can fly. It's that easy.
I have so many questions about power of attorney.
Well, some powers of attorney are for finances and others are for healthcare decisions.
A power of attorney designates an agent who would make decisions on your behalf.
While making a power of attorney, you have the ability to control your agent's power.
You also have the ability to decide when that POA would take effect.
Wait, am I giving away all my rights?
Power of attorney isn't a license to make any decision for you, just those that you've specified.
Your agent should be somebody that's working in your best interest, but it should also be somebody that you would trust.
What if they try to abuse their power?
Protective measures like third-party accounting, secondary signatures, defined spending and gifting limits can help protect against financial exploitation. An agent's powers can always be limited by a customized power of attorney, and they can be revoked by you or the court if the power of attorney is abused.
So carefully drafted estate planning documents can help ensure that your finances are monitored, but not abused.
If you or someone you know is being exploited, please report to Aging Services Bureau at 844-277-9300 or the Legal Service Developer at 1-800-332-2272. This message is sponsored by the DPHHS Aging Service Bureau.
Respite care is amazing. If you are capable of doing it, the rewards are beyond measure.
Stephanie Young, respite care provider, on the unexpected benefits of helping people in need.
Being a respite care provider is an amazing experience. It's something that what you give back 100-fold. You receive so much more than you could ever imagine.
To find out how to change lives, including your own, go to respite.mt.gov.
Hi, folks. Welcome to Aging Horizons, which is brought to you by the Department of Public Health and Human Services. I'm your host, Brian Lamore. And we're talking about the 52nd Annual Governor's Conference on Aging. This has been going on a long time. A lot of seniors and professionals have been attending the conference. And this year, they're working with M4A also. So we have two wonderful guests from both those organizations. On my left, we have Adrian Cotton. You're the director of M4A. Welcome to the show. And on my right, we have Jackie Strokel. You're the Aging Services Governor's Conference Coordinator. Welcome back to the show yourself.
Thank you.
Great to have you here. And Jackie, you know, the Governor's Conference, boy, it's been going on for 52 years.
Yes.
And what are some of the objectives of the Governor's Conference, and how do you meet those objectives?
Well, we do a collaboration. The Governor's Advisor Council is actually one that hosts and sponsors this conference, mm-hmm. and they work in collaboration with Aging Services. And of course, this year we're collaborating with AARP and with M4A. Mm-hmm. And our focus is to get information, education out there to our seniors to meet the needs of our Montana, older Montanans. We have a lot of topics and issues that are issues for older Montanans, and that's mainly the focus.
Yeah, and it's great that you can bring outstanding speakers to talk on these topics. You know, sometimes they're from around the nation, mm-hmm. and they can inform seniors. And this year, you're going to be doing it virtual.
Yes.
How do you do it virtual?
Very carefully.
Yes.
We are doing it virtually, mostly because we really want to get the communities involved. It's been a pretty challenging year for a lot of our older Montanans and for many of our communities. And so this is a way of bringing the communities back and back together again. Virtually, of course, allows them to watch statewide, mm-hmm. and it allows people to attend either in front of their computer or to get together in their community to watch it, but not have to travel.
Mm-hmm. And an advantage, I'm going to correct you, it's nationwide and worldwide they could attend.
Yes.
They just need to know ahead of time.
Yes.
And you're coordinating with M4A and the area and AARP, and they bring some certain interest for topics, right? What is the general theme for the conference this year, and how are you working to meet that theme?
Okay, so actually the national theme for the conference is Communities of Strength, and we added to that Be the Connection. Mm-hmm. And I think being a national theme, because the whole nation has been through quite a challenge this year, that we felt that that was a great theme to go with. Mm-hmm. Instead, it's been a challenging process. Now, the theme is basically, I feel, is Montana is a very resilient state. And last year, again, I mentioned it has been challenging, mm-hmm. especially for older Montanans. And we're hoping to, it's time to come back as a community. And I believe that is where the governor is at mm-hmm. at this point, too.
Exactly. Now, how can people get information on how to attend this conference locally or virtually?
We will be promoting that through our website, which they will probably show the mm-hmm. website link on this show. And we'll be promoting it through our Aging in 406, which is our Facebook site, and through other avenues, through our senior centers, and through other avenues like newsletters.
Okay. So, Adrian, you're with the M4A organization. Can you tell us what the M4A organization is, and how does it meet the needs of seniors?
Absolutely. Thank you, Brian. So, the Montana Area Agencies on Aging Association is a nonprofit organization that is dedicated to promoting the independence, the dignity, and the economic viability of Montanans, of older Montanans. So we are the leading source of information for Montana policymakers and service providers on how to enhance the lives of older Montanans.
Yeah, well, that's good.
It's pretty fantastic. So M4A represents 10 area agencies on aging across the state that provide critical supports and services, things that you're probably familiar with, like Meals on Wheels, homemaker services, things like that.
Oh, yeah. They're the service delivery arm of the state unit on aging, and they work through senior centers and other organizations to bring those services to seniors. So it's great to have you here. And how are you working with the governor's conference? What influence or what topics are you wanting to see addressed at the conference?
We are working really hard to capitalize on the leadership that Governor Gianforte has brought with enhancing broadband access across the state. Mm-hmm. And so we're working really hard with senior centers to make sure that people can attend this conference from Main Street rather than having to travel to all of our larger cities to participate. Mm-hmm. We are hosting a pre-conference on the 13th of August to allow older Montanans to go to their senior centers, all of our participating senior centers. Mm-hmm. Actually, the Montana Area Agencies on Aging Association procured a grant. And as a result of that grant, we are purchasing for participating senior centers monitors, computers, and audiovisual mm-hmm. equipment, and if needed, assistance in getting access to the internet. And we're allowing older Montanans to come together to talk about what the service plan should look like for the next 3 years, what priorities should be in services, and updating older Montanans on how the recent legislative session is going to impact their lives.
Mm-hmm. And the service plan is how the Area Agencies on Aging will deliver services to the unique needs of each of their counties and, well, even down to cities, too. So senior input is very, very important. But it's interesting that you're getting grants to do that. That's wonderful. Was that very difficult?
It's been a trial. Actually, the grant that we procured was meant to reduce the impacts of COVID-19. Mm-hmm. And during the commission of this grant, we did a study to talk to older Montanans across the state. What we learned is that the majority of, 40% of older Montanans are experiencing moderate to severe isolation and loneliness. Mm-hmm. Half of older Montanans live alone. The other half generally live with just one other person, which really showed us that we needed to invest in our community gathering places. Mm-hmm. So rather than invest in our own services within our own nonprofit, we are outfacing and pushing the money out to the communities to really pull our communities back together and enforce that we need to be working together, talking together, mm-hmm. eating together, working together.
Oh, that's great. Well, we've quickly drawn to a close on our first segment, and we'll be talking more about the Governor's Conference on Aging, which is September 14th, and the pre-conference, which is September 13th. Stay tuned. You'll want to know this information.
I think the most pleasant surprise when we turned 65 and signed up for Medicare Part B was finding out about our Welcome to Medicare preventive visit.
It was free, and it gave us the opportunity to visit with our doctors and establish a plan for our health going forward.
They reviewed our medical history, measured our height, weight, blood pressure, and counseled us on other risk factors.
To learn more about Medicare's free or low-cost preventive and wellness benefits, call your local SHIP counselor at 800-551-3191. I mentioned it's free, right?
Twice.
I've been shooting since I was young. It's something I've always enjoyed. I wasn't feeling like myself, then my friend noticed. He asked if he could hold onto my guns temporarily. At first, I was a little shocked. But then I agreed. I think he saved my life that day.
This is Bill. He just received his new Medicare card and is following some simple rules to protect himself from fraud. He knows to never give out his Medicare, Social Security, or bank number over the phone. And this is Nancy. She knows that to detect any problems, she always reads her Medicare Summary Notice or Medicare Advantage EOB to make sure the billing is correct. Both Bill and Nancy know that anything suspicious can be reported to Montana SMP at 1-800-551-3191.
Here in Montana, we love our outdoor activities. Unfortunately, few of them are risk-free. Indeed, Montana is second in the nation per capita in head injuries that can destroy the lives of people we love. That's why you should insist your family always wear protective helmets. But you can do even more. When you fill out your vehicle registration this year, circle the Y and donate a dollar to support traumatic brain injury prevention and education. Now that's using the old noggin.
Hi folks, welcome back to Aging Horizons. I'm your host, Brian Lamorne, and I'll continue our discussion on the 52nd Governor's Conference on Aging, which is being done this year in cooperation with AARP and M4A. So Jackie, what's important this year is that there's no cost to attend the conference, which is pre-conference, September 13th and September 14th.
Yes.
No cost is wonderful.
Well, it is. I think what it does is really opens it up the avenue for more seniors to attend, because I know sometimes it could be cost prohibitive for them. But also with it being at the senior center, it just allows more people to attend that without worrying about that. So it is no cost, especially being in the new virtual world.
Yes,
we
yes.
thought, well, this will entice them to come, we hope, and such. And so, yeah, there will be more opportunity for them to attend freely in the comfort of their own home or within the community. And do you want me to talk about the topics?
Well, I was about to say, if you go to the senior center, you probably get a free lunch or a minimal cost and free snacks and coffee breaks.
I'm thinking so.
That'd be fun, and you can meet your neighbors and friends, and it'll be a good time. But now let's go into the topics, because it's always so important. Let's start with the theme of the conference and then how the topics are meeting that theme.
Okay. So the theme of the conference, again, is community's strength, be the connection. Mm-hmm. And we felt that was a good segue into what AARP is really working toward in their grants, which is livable communities. And they have several granted communities out there that are going to be presenting on the panel on what they're doing within their communities. They are also bringing in a keynote speaker from the head office to come and talk about the livable communities and such.
Great.
And I think I'll probably integrate into what we call age-friendly and dementia-friendly communities, because it all kind of ties in together. Also, some of the other topics, of course, Cara Roston is going to present information about suicide prevention. That's been sort of a critical issue in the state this last year. And they will be looking at topics in caregiving and Alzheimer's, which is always very popular. And we're looking at fall prevention. We're having a group come in, especially there's some fall prevention grants out there, and they're pulling in information about that. And we're, of course, looking at frauds and scams and elder abuse as some of our other topics. And then AARP is going to have their trivia game at the very end, and we're hoping to have other topics such as a cooking demonstration along with that. So those are just a few of the topics that we're going to be covering at the conference.
Mm-hmm. And you know, those are all so important. With our communities changing so much right now, to have a senior-friendly community is so important. Off the top of your head, do you know a few points of what's important for a senior community?
Well, one of the things they're talking about with the senior community is the looking efforts of neighborhoods, towns, and cities to become great places for people of all ages. Mm-hmm. And they can benefit from the adoption of those policies and programs. But mostly the senior community is, what is age-friendly, how to get around, how to focus on the needs of the seniors there and activities for the seniors there. We are an aging population. Mm-hmm. And you know, I think sometimes it gets so geared toward the younger that we kind of forget our older group is out there, mm-hmm. that are trying to still stay very active within the community. Mm-hmm. And Adrian may be able to add to that a bit.
Sure, yeah. Well, AARP Montana, you know, they do a wonderful job. They have over 145,000 members in Montana. Yeah. And the Livable Communities effort has been endorsed by the Montana League of Cities and Towns. They've shown great leadership. We have Roundup and Bozeman, and recently Superior has joined this effort. What Livable Communities does is takes a tried and true infrastructure that's been used all across the state in many different communities and states, and provides a blueprint for how you can coalesce all of your community organizations across all the different spectrums, whether you're talking about anything in human services. But it really is meant to improve, like Jackie said, the lives of all ages. So mm-hmm. helping keep our kids here at home, whether it's talking about zoning regulations or traffic, how traffic moves through the town. There are mm-hmm. tons of ways that Livable Communities is working hard in Montana to make our places better for all ages.
Oh yeah, and what's really nice about these conferences is then we have such diversity in Montana. You know, what works in Billings might not work in Wolf Point. They're able to work together. They're able to talk to each other. It's those connections that bring those things together. And I imagine, Adrian, that your website has a lot of information on it. And besides registration information, if someone was to go to the website on the screen, what could they find there as it addresses senior issues?
Thank you. Yes, we have tons of information on our website. We have great information about services, where to access them, who the key people are in your own community. And then particularly for the conference, we're going to have a list of the participating senior centers, which mm-hmm. I anticipate will be a pretty long list, so that people know where to go in their own communities to tune in.
And I imagine those senior centers, if you're on the list there, they'll be contacting you. They'll let you know what's going on. They have a regular group of individuals that do attend. Are the senior centers, a lot of them opened up now that COVID is sort of waning?
Yes, which is fantastic. We get lots of questions from senior centers across the state, and M4A is also hosting monthly calls with senior centers across the state to help them understand how to open safely, how to address questions from participants, and really how to encourage people to come back out in their communities, get together.
Start socializing and get proper nutrition. There's a lot of education that goes on with that. And I know the state website has that information. So between the two of you, you got great resources if people just access them.
Yes,
yeah. Get to it. Well, we're drawing quickly to a close on this show, or this segment, and want to reinforce that, you know, the Governor's Conference is coming up September 14th for the senior centers, and the day before, they're looking at input from seniors virtually also about the service plans that your local area agencies and senior centers need to evaluate, and they want to talk to seniors, let them tell them what they need to plan for in the near future to better meet their needs. But the conference is going to be great. We heard a lot of great topics that they were mentioning there, and we'll be talking more about that in our next segment. But keep those dates in mind, because it's free. Can't beat that.
Elder abuse is a growing problem, and it's happening right here in our Montana communities. At least 1 in 10 older adults are victims of physical or emotional abuse, financial exploitation, or neglect. To get help or report elder abuse, call your local area agency on aging or Adult Protective Services at 1-844-277-9300.
Every 65 seconds, someone is affected with Alzheimer's or other dementias. Many become isolated at a time when help is most needed. If you or someone you love is affected, help is available, both for people with memory loss and their caregivers. Memory loss can feel frightening, but you are not alone. Call the free 24/7 Alzheimer's Association helpline, 800-272-3900, for guidance and support.
You mean I can get help paying my prescription drug premiums?
Let me get this straight. I could be eligible for help with my family's prescription premiums even though I own my own home?
And our assets won't be counted.
If you're a Montana resident enrolled in the Medicare Prescription Drug Program, you could be eligible for help paying your premiums. Call or visit the Big Sky RX website today to find out, even if you think you're over income.
What do you know about that? I'm eligible.
When I found out it was diabetes, my first thought was, Barb, you need help. You have to take control of this. There is help. My doctor gave me a phone number. I called and signed up with a diabetes educator. There is help. I have to put blinders on when I walk past the bakery counter. I can feel my blood sugar go up. You succeed a little at a time. If you have diabetes, help is available. You do not have to do it alone.
Ask your doctor about diabetes education or visit Montana211.org.
Welcome back to Aging Horizons. I'm your host, Brian Lamorne. We're continuing our discussion about the 52nd Governor's Conference on Aging. 52 years. Almost eligible to be a senior itself. And it's coming up pretty quick here. September 14th is for senior centers and individuals to listen to presenters. September 13th is for individuals to have input on the senior plans, senior planning for senior services into the future. Now, Jackie, you put on the Governor's Conference on Aging, and it is also presented by the Governor's Advisory Council. What does the Governor's Advisory Council do, and why are they important?
So the Governor's Advisory Council, I actually hosted this conference for many, many years. And they are an 11-member council that is appointed by the Governor, and their majority of the 11 are 60 and over, so they really are able to tap into a lot of the senior issues. And their role is to advise the Governor and the Department of any aging issues and the long-term care issues and concerns that come up. They have been the sponsor and host of the conference in collaboration with Aging Services since its inception. Mm-hmm. And of course, this year we're very fortunate to have AARP and M4A as part of that collaboration, which I think just adds to the pot.
Mm-hmm. And let's quickly go over some of the presenters again, because that's important. These are important topics for Montana seniors, and it's always fascinating. You know, talking to you guys for a half hour, I've learned so much, much less for a whole day. And the conference provides that opportunity. What are some of the presenters?
So we are still tying up some of the presenters out there. We will have somebody that AARP is bringing in at the national level that will talk about livable communities. Of course, Carl Roston will be one of our keynote speakers that will talk about the health and well-being, but as it relates to suicide prevention. We also have falls prevention that I think Melissa Dale is coming in from the State Health Department that will be talking about that, and especially the grants that are out there for falls prevention and such. And then, of course, other topics include Social Security, include frauds and scams, and elder abuse. And we're still pulling together the conference folks for that. Mm-hmm. And by the time this program airs, that we will have all that stuff listed on to the website there. And we encourage seniors to go to the conference website to look at the agenda as it comes together.
As it comes together. And there's so much great information. What's nice, too, is that the conference provides the attendee the opportunity to see a person, mm-hmm. kind of get to learn them. And if they have questions, they can contact them after the conference
Addressed. One of the interesting things this year, too, is that we are doing our sponsorship booths virtually. Yeah. And it allows for people to tap into those virtual booths and talk to individuals there. Alzheimer's Association is one of our keynote speakers. I think Lynn Maloney and Whitney will be part of that group that will be doing a breakout session for us. But they'll be available to talk to folks virtually.
Oh. That is amazing. I'm going to definitely tune in and catch this because it's free. It's great. And Adrian, you know, when I put on conferences, it was really important to get different groups, provider groups, people that provide services together, because Everybody does the same thing differently, particularly throughout the state. And you're putting together a special program or a council for senior centers, right? Tell us more about that. That's pretty innovative.
Yes, thank you, Brian. We're so excited about this. So our participating senior centers are, we're coalescing them into the Senior Services Advisory Council for M4A. Yeah. And what this is going to provide is a mainline communication tool for folks all across the state in rural Montana. We're going to be talking about how to self-advocate, how to help develop policies, both at a local level with your local government, how to do outreach to your legislature, and then also to help craft the M4A position when we're working with the governor and with the Montana legislature. What are the priorities? And they should not always be decided in Helena.
Yeah.
We need to be talking to people who are directly impacted by the decisions that are made by our leaders.
Mm-hmm. And by becoming locally active, they can influence the local people that when they come to Helena, they've already been educated. That's what's important during the campaign.
Yes, absolutely. We have one of the largest voting bases in the entire state, and we really need to work on making sure that people know who to talk to and how to self-advocate.
Well, now, if individuals want to be involved with this, I mean, is this just kind of through the senior centers that they're going to work their way up, or can external people be involved in this process?
We want everyone who wants to be involved to be involved. So the advisory council membership is through senior centers, but if you go to our website, we have ways to contact and get involved. We really firmly believe in grassroots efforts and helping people know what's going on, getting involved, and who to contact at every level.
Mm-hmm. Because right now what's happening is they're going to be reviewing the senior plan or the senior funding and programs that seniors want to have. They want individual input. You want probably business leadership that are involved in that too. And it's not too soon to prepare for 2 years from now.
It sure isn't. And again, you know, with the leadership that we've seen under Governor Gianforte and the broadband access, there's never been a better time to get involved and really utilize the communication tools that we have.
That's great. And Jackie, with the little bit of time we have left, please recap the conference again and why it's important to attend.
Okay, so again, the theme of the conference is Communities of Strength, Be the Connection. And mm-hmm. we think this is a great topic for this year, especially with the involvement of the other programs. To remind people that the conference itself is going to be September 14th from 8 to 5, and it'll be just a one-day conference, but the pre-conference, when we kind of tagged it as the Aging Summit, mm-hmm. that will be on the 13th of September, and I think we're looking at probably a half day for that. And then that the conference is free to all, and it covers all the sessions and the summit itself and the promotion of senior and community centers is, I think, the most exciting part of this conference, of getting people really very, very involved. The important thing is it's no cost to attendees.
No cost to do it. Boy, you know, when I was putting on the conference and summits, I wish I had virtual tools. It would have been so much easier. So thank you both for what you're doing for Montana seniors and for your service. This is wonderful, and it's making for a better Montana. Great. And for our viewers, again, you know, we're talking to Governor's Conference on Aging. It's coming up September 14th. There's a summit the day before. If you were to go to the M4A website or the Area Agency or the Senior website, you can get more info. Thanks for joining us.
Special thanks to the Department of Public Health and Human Services for their continued support. Hosts on Aging Horizons are program specialists at the Montana Office on Aging. Production facilities provided by Video Express Productions. For more information about Aging Horizons, call the Department of Public Health and Human Services toll-free at 800-332-2272.